Hey everyone, I'm back with book recommendations, some of my favorite books, and this time it's on my favorite spiritual books. My recommendations for the books that'll help you to get close to God, help you to know God better, help you to feel Him, experience Him, deepen your relationship with Him in your life, get your prayers answered, and really just grow in the spiritual life. So many times we feel dry. So many times we feel empty. So many times we just feel like we've hit a plateau and we don't know where to go. We don't know what to do. And people, oh my gosh, if you read books, sometimes I've read some of these books and I've learned things I could have never even thought of in 100 lifetimes. They change your life. So these are some of my favorite recommendations. Number one, Introduction to the Devout Life by St. Francis de Sales. This book is said to be one of the top six devotionals of all time in history. One of the best books ever written. Now, the reason that I love this book so much is because unlike all the other spiritual books or most of the other spiritual books out there, this is one of the very few resources that was written for lay people. In other words, not nuns and not priests. It was written for Catholics, you know, who are living in the world. This book literally covers everything. If I could offer you one book, this would be it. This is my number one recommendation for growing in holiness and growing closer to God. And I think every Catholic should read this book before they die. Every Catholic. And of course, I'm going to be linking all of these books I'll be talking about in the descriptions below so you can see them. But here's what you need to know about this book. This book is really good because it starts out with 10 meditations that'll help you to grow closer to God, that'll help you to think about your own life, to meditate on who you are, where you're at, where you're going, who do you want to be? What would happen if you died tonight? Would you be ready? What would you want to change? What would you want to do? I mean, this is really good stuff to think about, but then it goes into every part of the Christian life, from how we talk and how we walk and how we control our temper, how we control our lust, how we control gossip, how we control those things that we struggle with. I mean, we all have our weaknesses. We all have our struggles. We all struggle with prayer. How do you pray? How do you meditate? How do you actually really know God on a deeper level? This book literally covers every aspect of your life, and I would highly recommend it. The second book I would recommend is this. I Believe in Love, especially if you have a hard time seeing God as love. If you have a hard time seeing God as someone who's on your side. If you're like me, growing up, I always thought God was judging me. I always thought God was mean, that He was always angry, that He was always pounding His foot, pounding His fist. If I did something right, great. You don't get a reward for it. That's what you're supposed to do. But heh, if you do something wrong, you're going to hear about it, you're going to feel about it, and you're going to be punished. You know what? So many of us do not come close to God because we don't even know who He is. We have a false understanding of who God is. And this book has the philosophy of St. Thérèse of Lisieux, also known as the little child, the little flower. And so it's her philosophy. It's by Father Jean C.J. Delbay. And it's one of the best books that I can recommend. I mean, it starts talking about the love of God right in the first chapter. It talks about how to trust God, how to have confidence in God, how to abandon yourself to God completely so you have no worries and no fears, and you can find peace and happiness. Isn't that what we all look for? This book is so simple. Some people don't like it because they say it's too simple. It's so simple. It's magnificent. It's brilliant. It's earth-shattering. Literally, St. Thérèse became a saint through simplicity. You don't have to climb mountains. You don't have to go to India and work with dying people in the middle of the streets. You can become a saint right where you are, in your own home, in your own town, in your own neighborhood, and this book will help you with that. My next book, and this is one of my all-time favorite books, it's called The Fire Within. You can tell one it's one of my favorites because it's all faded and it's falling apart at the seams. And if you look at it, it's all underlined and exclamation points and circled and everything else. I've read this book like so many times. And I'll just be honest with you, this book is hard to read. If you're not serious about going to heaven, don't read this book. If you're not serious about being a Catholic and following Jesus, don't read this book, because this book is for serious Christians. It's for serious Catholics. It's literally will take you from the plateau that we're all on. Most of us grow up praying when we're 3, 4, 5 years old, and our prayers don't evolve much when we get to 10, 12, 14, and they don't evolve much after that. We just talk to God, talk, 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 and ask, but we never know God in a deeper level, and this book will springboard you to a deeper relationship with God. It'll get you to the deepest depths of faith. Things that the saints experienced, you can experience too, and this book will show you how. It'll start with vocal prayer, how to talk to God, but also how to listen. How do you know His will? How do you know when He's speaking to you? How do you know what's from God and what's not from God? How do you discern things? What are the three secrets that you need to know that will help you? If you practice these three things, these will get you so close to God that most people on earth don't get that close in life. And if you're really, you've been doing spiritual reading and you're just someone who wants to take your faith to a new level, get this book, A Fire Within, Father Thomas Dubé. He's one of the mystics of our time. And this is the philosophy and kind of the theology of St. John of the Cross and St. Teresa of Avila. And he talks about them, breaks them down, and makes them for ordinary average men and women living in the world like you and me. Get the book. Lastly, one of my favorites is Imitation of Christ. It's of the old school, so to speak. It's hard hitting. It doesn't pull any punches. If you just like it, just hit me with it. Just tell me what to do and how to do it. Tell me why I'm a sinner. Tell me how I need to fix it. This book is for you. What I love about this book, you can just open it up, let's say, to, you know, we'll just say chapter 18. Look at chapter 18. That's it. It's one chapter, it's one page. So you read that, you meditate on it, you think about it for a while, and then you move on to chapter 19, which isn't that much longer. Each one's about a page or two, sometimes three. They're digestible, so you can take a page each day, grow in holiness, learn something, practice it for a couple days, go to the next chapter, read it, practice it for a couple days, and this will kick you in your butt in a good way, in a holy way, in a saintly way. This book will really help you to grow in holiness. If that's what you're looking for, then this is the book for you. Lastly, a couple honorable mentions of my favorite books that, you know, that I just want to mention real quick. Classics like Interior Castle, St. Teresa of Avila, Spiritual Exercises by St. Ignatius. This is like 40, I believe it's 40 meditations that you do for 1 hour a day, every day. Like, this book is serious. This book will literally get you to heaven. It will help you to come closer to God. I did it for Lent. If you want to do something for Lent, you know, give up time. Give up time every day. Now, I did it for an hour a day. You don't need to do it for an hour a day. You could do it for 10 minutes, 20 minutes. But my meditations were so good and it brought me so close to God, I just kept going and going and going. But these things, one a day, every day, by the end of this program, you will be closer to God. You will be a better Catholic. You will be a better Christian. And you will be a better person. This is a spiritual classic. And last but not least, Brother Lawrence, Practicing the Presence of God. God is around us at every moment of every day, and we hardly even think about Him. This book will help you to get past the external and get to the deeper part of the heart where you can know, love, and serve God in a way that's not boring, but that's practical and that's life-changing. These are my recommendations. If you have recommendations, put them in the comments below. And as always, down in the comment section, I'm going to be linking to all of these books. So if you want to buy them, check them out on Amazon, read some reviews. Make sure you also share this video so that other people can see the information. And last of all, make sure to subscribe if you haven't already and give me a high five. Thank you for watching today, and you have a great day.